inferior. Space between superior and middle conha. What is this space? Meatus nasi superior. Space between middle conha and inferior conha is meatus nasi medius. And between inferior conha and floor of the nasal cavity, here it is meatus nasi inferior. And space between concha nasalis and septum of the nose, all of this space. Meatus nasi communis, good. What opened into superior nasal meatus? Sinus sphenoidalis. Then posterior cells of ethmoidal bone and foramen sphenopalatinum. And foramen sphenopalatinum. That is superior nasal meatus. Next, middle nasal meatus, meatus nasi medius. It is largest sinuses are open. What is largest sinuses in English? Sinus maxillaris, maxillary sinus, and sinus frontalis. These two sinuses and also anterior and medial cells of ethmoidal bone. All of this structures opens into medial nasal meatus. And into inferior nasal meatus, canalis, nasolacrimalis, this open. It is necessary to repeat from osteology. From nasal cavity, air go to nasal part of pharynx, then go to oral part of pharynx, and then go to larynx. And larynx consists of cartilages. Do you know names of cartilages of the larynx? It is thyroid cartilage, below cricoid cartilage, and here it is arytenoid cartilages. In front, epiglottis, and small cartilages inside of plica aeroepiglottica, that is cartilaga corniculata and cartilaga conica. They are smallest cartilages and we have not got possibility to show them, but main cartilages we can see. Look, only half part of thyroid cartilage is here. It is half of thyroid cartilage. Another half is symmetrical, that is right part of thyroid cartilage, and the same on the left side should be. And thyroid cartilage has horns, superior horn and inferior horn. And two lamina, right and left lamina of thyroid cartilage join together and form an angle, angulus laryngeus. Below of thyroid cartilage we have cricoid. It looks like what? Like ring. It has arch, arcus, and lamina. Here it is lamina. And above of cricoid cartilage, it is superiorly. We have paired cartilage, cartilago arytenoide, here and here it is paired. And now I draw small diagram about cartilages of the larynx. It is not necessary to draw it. Look here. If we look on larynx superiorly from here, what we can see? That is two lamina of cartilaga tyroidea, that is this way. Below of it, cartilaga cricoidea, it consists of arch and lamina. And above of cartilaga cricoidea, here and here, cartilaga arytenoidea. And arytenoid cartilage has two processes. One of them is it's look inside of the larynx, and name of this process, processus vocalis, vocal process. Another, it's look laterally, and name of this process, processus muscularis, muscular process. That is vocal, and here it is muscular process. From vocal process start vocal ligament, ligamentum vocale, and this vocal ligament go to internal surface of what? What is it? Of thyroid cartilage. This is why vocal ligament, it is ligament between internal surface of thyroid cartilage and vocal process of arytenoid cartilage. It is clear. And space between these vocal ligaments and vocal processes, all of this space, it is vocal rima glottidis. It is vocal split or rima glottidis. And rima glottidis has two parts. First part is between vocal ligaments, and name of this part, pars intermembranata. And posterior part of this rima glottidis is between two cartilages. That is why name of this part is pars intercartilaginea, between two cartilages. Pars intercartilaginea here and pars intermembranata here. Now, some words about muscles. Muscles of the larynx, they divide into two groups. First group, that is constrictors and dilators. They are constrict or dilate rima glottidis. Another muscles, they are muscles which tense vocal ligament or muscles which relax vocal ligament. Is it clear? For example, it is muscle which start from cricoid cartilage and go to arytenoid cartilage. It is here and here. Musculus crica arytenoideus posterior. Crica arytenoideus posterior. Here. That is vocal processes, and here it is muscular process. And if muscular process we move backward, what happened to his vocal process? It's dilated. If we move muscular process backward, in this case, vocal processes dilate. That is why, what is the function of this muscle? Musculus crica arytenoideus posterior, it's dilate vocal processes and dilate rima glottidis. Another muscle also start from cricoid cartilage and attached to muscular process of arytenoid here and here, but it move muscular process laterally. Muscular process is moved laterally, and what happened with vocal process? It's joined together, constrict rima glottidis. It's this muscle is constrictor. Next muscle start from which? What is the name of this cartilage? Thyroid. Start from thyroid and go to arytenoid process, to muscular process of arytenoid cartilage. Musculus tira arytenoideus, from thyroid to arytenoid. Tira arytenoideus. Function the same like in crica arytenoideus lateralis. It's move muscular process laterally and join together or constrict vocal processes and constrict rima glottidis. Look here. These two muscles. It is. First muscle, musculus crica arytenoideus posterior. It is crica arytenoideus lateralis. And here, musculus tira arytenoideus. This is first, second, third. First, second, third muscle. Next muscle is here, that is arytenoid cartilage right, and here it is left, and between them we have muscle which join together both of these cartilages. Here it is between them. And name of this muscle, musculus arytenoideus transversus. If this muscle contract, it join together both arytenoid cartilage and constrict rima glottidis. And the same function in musculus arytenoideus obliquus, oblique muscle, musculus arytenoideus obliquus. It's here. And it is difficult to draw here, it is. One, two, two muscles, musculus arytenoideus obliquus, and here it is musculus arytenoideus transversus. another muscle. This muscle is between cricoid cartilage and thyroid. Here it is. Here it is. And here. Yeah. Between cricoid and thyroid cartilage. Here it is. Musculus cricket cerebus. Here. Musculus cricket cerebus. If this muscle contracts, it's moved thyroid cartilage forward. And what happened with vocal ligaments in this case? It's tense. But if vocal muscle is between thyroid cartilage and vocal process, here it is. It is vocal ligament, and inside of vocal ligament, here it is, vocal muscle, musculus vocalis. It's joined together and decreased space between thyroid and arytenoid cartilage and relax vocal ligament. Clear? And last two muscles are muscles which one of them decrease inlet into the larynx. Inlet into the larynx has name aditus laryngeus. And this muscle is musculus araepiglotticus. Musculus araepiglotticus. It is continuation of musculus arytenoideus obliquus. Musculus araepiglotticus is decrease aditus laryngeus. Another muscle, musculus tiroarytenoideus. Sorry, musculus tiroepiglotticus, tiroepiglotticus. It's dilate aditus laryngeus. It is most difficult part of next classes, muscles of the larynx. It is most difficult, and I recommend you to come here in evening till 6 o'clock. Now, the department open from 8 o'clock in the morning till 6 o'clock in the evening, and receive preparate of the larynx and show, look all of these muscles on the
paper. This one, I don't know. This one is because.
Yes. Look on, you will answer, here it is. I will show you muscle. What is the name of this muscle? This muscle, this. And last moment. That is internal structure of the larynx. We already said that inlet into the larynx, it is aditus laryngeus. Walls of aditus laryngeus. In front, it is epiglottis. Posteriorly, it is apex of arytenoid cartilage, here and here. Fold of mucous membrane between arytenoid cartilage and epiglottis here. It is plica araepiglottica. Plica araepiglottica, and between arytenoid cartilages, here it is, plica interarytenoida, that is aditus laryngeus. Laterally from plica araepiglottica, this space between thyroid cartilage and plica araepiglottica here, it is ventri or recessus piriformis. Recessus piriformis, you studied it. When you prepare pharynx. In pharynx also describes this processus piriformis. Inside of larynx, we have vestibulum laryngeus. It is space from inlet to fold. Name of this fold, plica vestibularis. Below, plica vocalis. Space between plica vestibularis and plica vocalis, here it is, ventriculus laryngeus. And space below of plica vocalis, all of these cavities, it is cavitas infraglottidis. And now you take your places and we draw one diagram, what necessary to know next time, internal structure of the larynx.
Internal structure of the larynx.
I'll check my email.
I think I should think about the rules.